Regardless of what you believe, 2024 has been a year of major shifts. Terrifying truths have come out. The evil deeds of powerful people have been exposed, and it seems like things are getting better after several years of struggle and strife. Nature is healing, as they say. But what if it isn't? What if this cleansing is nature's way of purging centuries worth of bad energy before everything comes to a stop? Before the end. There's a theory that this is exactly what's happening, and it was foretold by a very unlikely prophet, a psychedelic soul. Sunshine pop song from 1969 called Age of Aquarius by a band called The Fifth Dimension. Is there any truth to this prophecy? And just how deep do its references go? Let's find out. Welcome back. You're watching Conspiracy Vibes. And this is the song that predicted the end of the world. To get to the bottom of this conspiracy theory, we're going to break down the lyrics of the song and find out what they really mean, so we can relate it better to recent events. Plus, we aren't going to assume most of you know a song from 1969 off the top of your head. That would make you old. When the moon is in the seventh house and Jupiter aligns with Mars, then peace will guide the planets and love will steer the stars. Age of Aquarius appropriately opens up with some astrology. For those who don't know, the Age of Aquarius is an astrological age that began on January 20th, 2024, and is said to cause a shift in consciousness from me to we, resulting in relative peace and equality while new ideas are explored and creativity is allowed to flow. Sounds great, right? Hold that thought. Now, the seventh house being mentioned is the house of partnerships, which you might automatically assume relates to romantic partnerships. However, this isn't really the case, as this is the source of the me to we shift we just mentioned. When the moon is in the seventh house, which happens around 2.5 days out of every month in everyone's horoscope, the welfare, happiness, and security of everyone around you is just as important as your own. You care about your fellow man and women, strangers included, as if they are your own family, or even a part of yourself. Jupiter aligns with Mars semi-frequently as well, roughly every 2 or 3 years. This particular conjunction is where the creativity and new ideas come from, as it marks the beginning of a time of advancement, learning, and growth. It's basically what our lives could be if we made the most of our potential and put our hearts and souls into everything we did and allowed our inner creativity to shine. But hey, that's something we should all strive to do more anyway. While the events described in these first lines aren't particularly rare or mysterious, we're used to experiencing them on a smaller individual basis. In the Age of Aquarius, the effects of these events are being felt by not just everyone we share this planet with, but everything within our solar system. Then peace will guide the planets, and love will steer the stars. Now, there's clearly a lot of hate and conflict happening on Earth, but does it seem like things have been changing in a more positive direction recently? Like perhaps a certain former president is being revealed as the major buffoon he really is?
In Springfield, they're eating the dogs, the people that came in. They're eating the cats. They're eating the pets of the people that live there. And this is what's happening in our country.
And maybe even the tide of a war is turning as the underdog strikes back against an invading force.
They're eating the dogs. They're eating the cats. Eat the cat. Eat the cat. They're eating the dogs. They're eating the cats. Eat the cat. They're eating the dogs. The people that came in, they're eating the cats. They're eating the pets of the people that live there. And this is what's happening in our country.
Could we be approaching a time of peace and love? It definitely seems like it. Let's move on to the bridge of the song. Harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abounding, No more falsehoods or derisions. Golden living dreams of visions, mystic crystal revelation, and the mind's true liberation. Aquarius, Aquarius. This part is where things get interesting. At this point, the song is describing a kind of age of truth, where all secrets are revealed, and those revelations lead to harmony, understanding, sympathy, and trust. The true liberation of our minds. With those concepts in mind, let's look back on everything that has happened so far this year. The Epstein files were declassified. Secret tunnels were discovered under a New York synagogue. Cat Williams went on Shannon Sharpe's podcast and unleashed hell.
Like, all of these dudes are co-entwined and they share secrets, and this is the age of truth, and the truth doesn't need to be scared of the fact that people tell lies. Race is not where the line is drawn. It's God's side and the other side. And we don't care nothing about the other side. Period. Period. All of these big dick deviants is all catching hell in 2024. It's up for all of them. It don't matter if you Diddy or whoever you is, T.G. Jakes, any of them, all lies will be exposed. That's all. And anyone who takes that the wrong way, know why they take it the wrong way. The truth is the light.
Aliens showed up at a mall in Miami, followed by an attempted cover-up.
It involves talk of alien sightings at Bayside Marketplace. On New Year's Day, there was a massive police response in downtown Miami. More than 50 young people armed with sticks began fighting. Police say juveniles were also sending off fireworks, causing chaos.
So now, people are posting online saying that police weren't there to handle a group of rowdy teens, but rather 8 to 10 feet tall, shadowy aliens. Conspiracy theories are saying a big creature could be seen standing in front of the entrance to the shopping area, Bayside. Today, the phrases Miami Mall and Aliens of Miami have been among the top 10 searches on Twitter's trending tab. Twitter, of course, now called X. And Google News even has several reports questioning the event.
So we reached out to the Miami Police Department. They issued a statement saying in part, quote, there were no aliens, UFOs, or ETs. No airports were closed, no power outages. Facepalm emoji was included in the statement.
A psychic predicted Trump's downfall on Fox News. That remains to be seen.
Paula Roberts is the English psychic who is on set to give us a reading right now. I would like, Paula, for you to give me a reading on President Trump.
Just the one card?
One card.
One card. Let's do just one card. We like that one.
Uh-oh. What is that?
I do recognize that I'm at Fox TV. A sense of loss. A sense of loss. But it's very specific. No, let me move on. It's a sense of loss. It's as if he may be thinking more about what he's lost and not still taking full advantage of what he still has.
That's a great interpretation, Paula.
It's true. It's true. I don't make it up.
Boeing's decades of maximizing profits, cutting corners, and mismanagement began to unravel after an emergency door flew off of a 737 at 16,000 feet.
We are emergency. We are depressurized.
A terrifying moment on board an Alaska Airlines plane.
We have 177 passengers.
After part of the fuselage blew off 16,000 feet in the air, a panel sealing an unused exit suddenly detached.
There was, I guess, a boy and his mother were sitting in that row, and his shirt was sucked off him and out of the plane. And his mother was holding onto him.
No one was sitting in the seats next to the gaping hole. And remarkably, no one was seriously injured.
Had the aircraft been at higher altitude, at cruising altitude, for example, maybe more passengers would have unbuckled their belt, could even have been moving about the cabin, and then certainly there would have been a risk of loss of life with passengers potentially able to be sucked out of the aircraft.
The Federal Aviation Administration has now grounded 171 Boeing 737 MAX 9 planes, most of them being flown by United Airlines and Alaska Airlines. They are not used by Canadian Airlines. The National Transportation Safety Board is investigating. Boeing says it's supporting that work and that safety is its top priority. But passengers are nervous.
Not the most, making me the most confident this morning to get on a flight.
In 2019, Boeing grounded its 737 MAX 8 planes after hundreds died in two crashes. Last month, the company urged airlines to inspect more than 1,300 MAX planes for a possible loose bolt in the system that helps maintain cabin pressure.
Boeing has some hard questions to answer. I have confidence that they will answer them fully and truthfully, but the quality assurance issues at Boeing definitely need to be addressed and carefully scrutinized.
This MAX 9 was almost brand new, flying only 145 times since mid-November, only adding to the questions for Boeing to answer.
Caroline, what will investigators be looking at?
Well, they need to figure out exactly how this happened, Ian, and determine if this is a problem that affects this one specific plane or if this is an issue that affects the entire MAX 9 fleet. We also know they're going to be listening to flight recorders. And as of this afternoon, they still hadn't found the missing panel, you know, the one that flew off the plane. They're looking for that because they're hoping to see if there's any scrapes or any markings on it that will help them determine how it flew off, as well as the bolts that were supposed to hold it together. They want to see if they're still in place.
We found out that billionaires are freezing themselves when they die so they can continue being societal leeches, when technology can bring them back to life.
Billionaires have lost their minds. 50 billionaires and millionaires have signed up to be frozen after death for a hope of being resurrected. And the cost is $50,000. The people who signed up for this that we know of are between the age of 30 and 80 years old. This is happening in Australia and in the US across multiple locations owned by the company Southern Chronics. Allegedly, these locations are considered as grave sites, but instead your body is frozen. In minus 310 degrees, your body's first placed inside these cooling chambers, and then you're transferred inside a vacuum sealed cryostat, basically a human vacuum seal with nitrogen. And apparently bodies can stay inside these vacuum chambers for hundreds of years without any deterioration. The company Southern Chronics is expanding their factory to multiple locations, with each location housing up to 600 bodies. But not only is the price $150,000 to be frozen, but you also have to pay a $350 annual fee. It's also worth noting that scientists haven't found a way to revive these bodies. So unless scientists are able to take the brain out and place it in some sort of robotic technology, there's probably no hope of being revived from the dead.
And Elmo absorbed the collective trauma of multiple generations after asking a simple question on Twitter.
Elmo asked us one question. It took nothing. Elmo just said, how is everybody? And the floodgates opened. As an internet user, I was embarrassed. The way that everybody just poured everything out to Elmo. If you didn't see it, Elmo tweeted, hey, just check it in. How is everybody? And 185 million views. What, a million replies? I don't know how many replies. It was absolutely crazy. Everyone just told Elmo everything that was happening in the moment. There's no better indication that we need universal mental health care than everyone responding to Elmo like he was in the room. That's absolutely insane. I can't believe, poor Elmo. Elmo probably smoking a cigarette right now, trying to calm down after the horrific stuff. Because some people were sending in video, like, all he said was, how is everybody? And then people under him, right underneath, like, they found me guilty, dog. Like, that's insane. This is not real right now. Go seek real help.
Elmo's tweet got tens of thousands of reposts and responses like, Elmo, I'm depressed and broke. Elmo, I just got laid off, and every day is like Big Bird crapped on me. Even more disturbing image when you remember that Big Bird is flightless. Now, not all. It takes effort. That's what I'm saying. That takes effort. Not all the responses were depressing. One user just said, hit this blunt, Elmo. Come on. Come on, Elmo does not smoke weed. Elmo is 3 years old. You're thinking of Cookie Monster.
Elmo responded to this outpouring of sadness by saying, "Wow, Elmo is glad he asked. Elmo will check in again soon, friends." Are we all now Elmo's oversharing co-worker? "Wow, the divorce thing sounds tough. Anyway, Elmo was just asking if you were going to use the printer."
And y'all, that was just January. There have been even more revelations and truth bombs since then, including the recent arrest of hip-hop mogul and apparent freak-off kingpin P. Diddy. Nobody could have predicted that the age of truth would look like 1,000 bottles of baby oil. And yet here we are. Cat Williams tried to tell us months ago.
$50 million four times. Four times. Just to protect my integrity and that virgin hole I was telling you about.
Right.
Because P. Diddy be wanting the body. And you gotta tell him no. You got to tell him no.
I did.
I can say them so freely. Kid, I need another one.
You here, get to another
Thank
one.
Thank you,
too,
sir. Thank you.
Come on.
Because early on, you was accusing me of being.
Just like the previous section of the song, it's clear that the harmony, understanding, sympathy, and trust described by the song aren't exactly here yet. Remember, the song's chorus says that this is the dawning of the age of Aquarius. But with the rate of the revelations happening, it's easy to see how all of these terrible events and reveals could be a purging. A purifying of energy that will bring about better and perhaps even great times. Times when people don't have to live in fear.
Our Haitian neighbors around the nation, I see you and I stand with you. Your lives are deeply valued by this Congresswoman, and your dreams, struggles, and aspirations matter. You are a part of our shared American story.
Times when those doing evil in the shadows are thrust into the light and forced to face the consequences of their actions.
Harvey, how you feeling?
Times when everybody can wake up in the morning without a looming dread hanging over them and negatively impacting their mental state, hopefully at least.
One thing that also really ran me earlier on is I had massive fear of the future. I'm like, how am I going to deal with this? What if this happens? How am I going to deal with that? So on and so forth. And what you realize is that if that's you and there's fear around the future, the reason there's fear around the future is because you are projecting current you too far ahead in time. Meaning the current you may not be equipped to deal with it. And that's okay.